Hi, this is Nino from Cinema 5D. We are here at NAB 2019 with Jeromy from
Atomos.
Cinema 5D at NAB 2019 is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video and photo solutions. Manfrotto, imagine more. Laowa, unique cinema and photography lenses. And Gudson, capture the world.
So it's 1 year since ProRes RAW was introduced last year here at NAB, right?
Correct.
One could say that the implementation has been a bit slow on the software side, I think.
Yeah.
And I think there is still not a single camera that records it inside, which is not your, you know, thing to deal with.
Yeah,
but you're still the only company that records ProRes RAW, except for DJI in their...
In the one drone.
Yeah, in the one drone. So where do you think the format is? Where does it go?
Okay, so last year... Both, you know, publicly and at the show, you know, in press releases and things, we alluded to the fact that this is an ecosystem we're building together, and a lot of companies will be brought into it. Don't worry, it's a 1.0, okay? And the people who obviously were an Atomos user already and a Final Cut user already could jump in. I can tell you there were 2 years of intense hard work between the ProRes team and the Atomos team. We didn't write SDKs. We sat in front of computers communicating across the Pacific Ocean, and we wrote code. And we tested the hell out of it in lots of different situations because we've got the inventors of ProRes, we've got the inventors of JPEG on that team. Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of knowledge in recording hardware. We've got a knowledge in software and what makes an efficient, really good CPU-GPU codec. So it is an amazing codec, and it is an evolution of the original ProRes. But it was 1.0. They had to write the SDK, right? That takes a long time. It's like, that's all, you know, when you're an engineer, you can't go, oh, I'm missing half the data, right? You go, where's my spec, where's my spec? And so you have to write that, that takes time. That's why we said 1.0, we said we've got to get this stuff in lots of different, and I'm doing my bit over here with the cameras. So I'm saying, you need to give me this, and then I can do it, right? They're over, Apple's sitting there going, I need to open up the ecosystem to support the recording of it and the processing of it. So what did they, we've got another editor in EDS. We've got an on-set dailies type of, you know, scratch assimilate and a lot of stuff that they do really well. Color front, real time on front, on set, telestream. All announced support for it. So when you can see that on their side, on the software side, they're knocking off parts of the ecosystem. Of course, Adobe's going to be a big target. Of course, a bunch of other software that I can't think of right now are going to be targets to finish workflows. Right?
Any news from Adobe? I mean, they said a year ago we're considering it, but since then we haven't heard anything. And there's just been a big update for Premiere, which doesn't have it still.
I think it's just time again. Yeah. I think the SDK probably wasn't to them fast enough, maybe. Yeah. But I can definitely tell you that I'm not hearing any whispers other than we want to support every format that we can inside their software. I don't have any specific information that I can kind of share publicly with you, but I would be extremely surprised if we're sitting here at NAB next year and there aren't a bunch of companies, including Adobe, that are supporting the format, is my prediction. I've said in my press releases that I know that 20 cameras will support ProRes RAW. Now that is insane. No matter which camera company you go to, three cameras, one camera, this camera, better than that. And that's all different formats for RAW. And you can turn this one up to 120 and 240 frames, and this one you can't on this camera. There's not a standard across. And then you look at the history, Sony's gone down that path. Let's do Xperia, let's do the whole end-to-end. How'd that go? Let's try and take over something. But if you go from a computer industry viewpoint, you use your friends and your partners to enable your ecosystem. And that's what we're doing. We're getting more and more cameras, that's our job. We're linking them faster into computer workflows. Mm-hmm. And it's Apple and their team's job to expand it, and they're doing it. So
Apple is always playing the long game, I think. So
absolutely. You know, and I like that game because it means you get a chance to learn and you get a chance to grow and you get a chance to improve your offerings consistently over time. And you know, let's make no mistake. There is one thing that's happening very clearly. Video is following the photo market. RAW is the new capture format. Processing is where it's at in the computer. And that path will happen.
So you're not the only one with a new compressed RAW codec, right?
Yes,
so there's
yes.
Blackmagic RAW.
Six months later,
Blackmagic RAW is out. People got excited about it.
Yes.
It's you know coming to existing Blackmagic cameras. Maybe also to other manufacturers' cameras because they claim it's open source. Everybody could use it or they would help them.
Yep.
What do you think about Blackmagic RAW? Is Blackmagic RAW ever coming to Atomos recorders?
I think the... You know, there's been a lot of talk from Blackmagic CEO around patents and RAW, and I don't think it's hard to figure out what's on his mind, right? Or what's happening in the background. We licensed compressed RAW from Red, and either it's RAW or something has happened to the RAW.
So just to inform our viewers, Red has a patent
on compressed RAW
technology.
So the moment you go from RAW to anything else, that is in a compressed form.
In a camera.
Well, not even in a camera. I'm not in a camera.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a very strong patent portfolio.
Yeah.
And to be honest, we respect IP. I'm not trying to get around Apple's ProRes licenses. And I'm working within them because I'm a good citizen in the world. I'm not trying to get around things unless, maybe it's unreasonable for those things to be happening. But I don't think it's unreasonable for Red's patents to be in the world. They spent a lot of money and time back in 2000 delivering big sensors and raw compression to make it work today, back then. And they did a lot of good work and they protected that work. And I'm, you know, very happy to be in business with them, licensing back to them with all the great ProRes RAW products that we deliver. Mm-hmm. So I would say to customers about, I think there's always room for multiple approaches. This is not the first camera company making a RAW format.
But if they would figure out if they had any patent issues,
yes,
and if they would figure them out, would you be willing to support it in the recorder?
Of course, I would be willing to support it if customers wanted it.
Yeah.
After working there for a long time, and there's been a lot of back and forth from customers about how there's animosity between the companies. You know, when people treat each other not well, there's never good blood between them. But I'm playing fair. I want to win the Super Bowl. I want to win the grand final against the best teams. And they're a formidable opposition. And I think we can work together if they so choose. I don't think that's going to happen in a hurry. And in the meantime, I am focused on ProRes RAW proliferation at all levels, software, camera, external monitoring, recording. And I'm going to enable that through things like Dolby Vision and partnerships. I call it the allied forces. You can decide what the other one is.
All right. Thank you, Jeromy, for the very interesting insight. Thanks for everybody for watching. Stay tuned to Cinema 5D for more news from NAB 2019 and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks.
Win $5,000 worth of gear in our NAB 2019 giveaway together with Serp and Joby. You can win a Genie 3-axis Pro Slider Epic Kit, a Magic Carpet Carbon Fiber Slider, and a Gorillapod with Genie Mini. To enter the giveaway, simply click the link below and follow the instructions. All winners will be drawn on April 30th. Good luck and stay tuned to Cinema 5D.